The living wall in Madeira Drive is Europe's longest and oldest green wall, but for what it looks like a mistake from the council, has now been partially cut down to allow work on a cycle lane. 8 Japanese spindle plants and a large fig tree were planted by the Victorians in 1872, and now all you can see is a grey wall exposed for the first time in about 150 years. I met with the councillor Robert Nemeth to find out more.
So we're at the bottom of Duke's Mound, along famous Madeira Drive in Kemp Town, one of the best tourist locations, scene of many different outdoor events, historic motor events, and of course home to the famous Madeira terraces and arches, which has a famous green wall behind them, Europe's longest and Europe's oldest, a key part of Brighton's precious natural environment.
Well, it was the longest until a few days ago.
It was the longest. It's got a big hole in the middle now, sadly, where contractors have suddenly chopped down 12 of these Japanese spindle plants, planted in 1872, no consultation, all part of the project to push through radical cycle lanes out of the blue. And we now find that the councillors themselves had taken their eyes off the ball so much that they weren't even aware of it when it happened.
So there isn't really an explanation why those plants have been chopped.
There was a preemptive drive to bodge in a cycle lane up Duke's Mound, which is the road we're standing on at this very second. And preemptively, they've chopped back these lovely plants behind us to maybe increase visibility for cyclists. I mean, I cycle up here, I run up here all the time, I've never had an issue. I run on this actual stretch where there isn't any pavement. It's not an issue, although there's a car behind us that's just put his foot down. It's not actually a busy part of the road at all. It's easy to run along or cycle along, so very silly. Well, I mean, the council, as it always does, has expressed some sort of regret, and we saw this same sort of regret when they took out the disabled parking spaces. It's the same sort of language that they often use now when they mess up for these sorts of things. Very sad indeed. An inquiry is going to be called, but I mean, ultimately, we'll probably see, even though the police are now involved, we'll probably see the council get away with it. Nobody will get fired, nobody will lose their jobs, nobody will resign, and they'll just get away with it and they'll do another stupid thing. So, I mean, the Brighton and Hove is essentially built on a cliff, so there are ultimately unstable sections, so they do need to, bit by bit, prop up the seafront wall, which is an essential part of looking after, you know, old infrastructure. But it's done with consultation, it's done with engineers, it's not suddenly done at a whim over a weekend when somebody thought the visibility wasn't quite right on a section of cycle lane.
Do you know how came we find out who actually made this decision?
Well, it was a council officer or set of council officers. Apparently the councillors weren't watching closely enough, so council officers acting on their own accord. It doesn't seem to have been the contractor's fault. That was the initial suggestion. So the contractor did what they were asked to do.
So the council asked the contractor to chop the trees without
a democratic mandate and without authority from councillors.